Welcome to St. Paul Lutheran Church. Thank you for worshiping with us online today. It is March 21st, the fifth Sunday in Lent, 2021. Let us begin with a time of confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the keeper of the covenant, the source of steadfast love, our rock and our redeemer. Gracious God, we find ourselves in circumstances we have not chosen, and we scurry to find any sense of normalcy. We know that you are the rock, yet we lean on other foundations. We know that you are sovereign, but we seek security in our own control. We know that you give comfort, but we elevate comforts of our own design. We know that you satisfy, but we keep scrolling. We know that you set us free, but addictions grip us tightly. We know that you call us to rest, but we keep struggling. By grace, forgive us. In mercy, meet us. By your Holy Spirit, equip us to walk in the newness of life with Jesus. Beloved, God's word never fails. The promise rests on grace. By the saving love of Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God, your sins are forgiven. And God remembers them no more. Journey in the way of Jesus. Amen.
Below, and us we
Lord of the new covenant, in Christ you draw all people to yourself. May we die with him to the powers of hate, and let him show us a world loved by you. Through Jesus Christ, who is the seed that bears much fruit. Amen.
The first reading is from the book of Jeremiah, the 31st chapter, beginning with the 31st verse. The time is coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the people of Israel and Judah. It won't be like the covenant I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the land of Egypt. They broke that covenant with me, even though I was their husband, declares the Lord. No, this is the covenant that I will make with the people of Israel after that time, declares the Lord. I will put my instructions within them and engrave them on their hearts. I will be their God, and they will be my people. They will no longer need to teach each other to say, "Know the Lord," because they will all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord. For I will forgive their wrongdoing and never again remember their sins. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
The Gospel according to John, the 12th chapter. Some Greeks were among those who had come up to the worship at the festival. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and they made a request. "Sir, we want to see Jesus." Philip told Andrew, and Andrew and Philip told Jesus. Jesus replied, "The time has come for the human one to be glorified. I assure you that unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it can only be a single seed. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their lives will lose them, and those who hate their lives in this world will keep them forever. Whoever serves me must follow me. Wherever I am, there my servant will also be, and my Father will honor whoever serves me. Now I am deeply troubled. What should I say? Father, save me from this time? No, for this is the reason I have come to this time. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven. "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard and said, "It's thunder." Others said, "An angel spoke to him." Jesus replied, "This voice wasn't for my benefit, but for yours. Now is the time for judgment of this world. Now this world's ruler will be thrown out. When I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to me." He said this to show how he was going to die. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Holy Week is coming. We're just a week away from the beginning of Holy Week. Next week is Palm Sunday, and as we hear the story of Jesus entering Jerusalem on a donkey to cheers of Hosanna from adoring crowds, we will begin our Holy Week journey. But in our passage from John 12 today, it's already Holy Week. In fact, that story of Jesus entering Jerusalem on the donkey comes before this passage in the very same chapter of John 12. And it's clear in our story today that Jesus is very sure, very certain of what's going to happen over the next few days and hours. This story brings together many of the themes that we've been talking about the last several weeks. Themes that lead us towards the cross, to Good Friday, and then to the empty tomb on Easter Sunday, and even beyond that to the risen Jesus, commissioning his followers to pick up the mission that he's both begun and completed, but which still needs to be communicated and implemented throughout the entire world. Remember, that mission is the good news that in Jesus, God's kingdom has come near to all of humanity. And the power of the kingdom, healing power, freeing power, forgiving power, death defeating power, that power is at work already in the world and in us, overturning the violence and death that human beings so naturally perpetuate. So in this story, we hear the reminder that it's Jesus who is the center of God's work in the world, God's kingdom, not the temple, not any church building, not any set of religious practices or worship services, Jesus and his body. He is the one who is lifted up. We heard about that in last week's stories. He is the seed who falls to the earth and dies, but is reborn and bears much fruit. He is the one who loses his life so that life might claim him and us forever, defeating death once for all. Jesus is the kingdom of God come near, and the world will be judged by his death and resurrection. But not the people of the world, the kingdoms of the world, the values and ways of this world that bring hatred, violence, and death are already judged in him. Jesus' death judges our sin, and in doing so, it saves us. We talked about that last week too, and here it is again, that juxtaposition of judgment and saving love. Now is the time for judgment of this world. Now this world's ruler will be thrown out. When I am lifted up, I will draw everyone to me. There are a few details in John 12 that are important, but maybe easy to overlook. This is a deliberately wide salvation foreshadowing. The Greeks, who are the Gentiles, they represent the world, have come to worship in Jerusalem too, and they want to see Jesus. So just like when Jesus was first calling that small group of disciples, when he calls Andrew and Philip, and then Philip tells Nathanael and invites him to come and see. Do you remember that story? We did that a few weeks ago. Now the Greeks come to Philip and say, we want to come and see too. We want to be disciples. And Philip does the same thing he did before. First he tells Andrew, and then they tell Jesus. And Jesus has this conversation, his final public conversation before his death, with a crowd that includes his disciples, but also these Greeks, the people of the world. Who can be a disciple of Jesus? Anyone and everyone, this passage reinforces. Anyone who wants to see Jesus, everyone who follows after Jesus, all who are drawn to him. As Jesus says in verse 32, when I'm lifted up, I will draw everyone to me. I've been thinking this week about how much our world needs to know, to see and hear the message, the good news of this Jesus. I don't know if you missed it, maybe if you blinked, and maybe if you don't watch TV, and maybe just because crisis and violence and death are so prevalent that we can pretty easily ignore them when they're not happening to us or to people who are like us. But this week, 8 people were shot and killed in Atlanta at 3 different Asian spas. 6 of them were women of Asian descent. Far away, people who are not like us, maybe most of us watching, they were killed by a white man, a 21-year-old, who loved Jesus, who believes in Jesus, and believed that those women represented a terrible temptation that he needed to rid himself of and the world. And then civic leaders, a white man with a uniform and a badge, told the country that this man was having a bad day and just reached the end of his rope. He also said that they didn't know that it had anything to do with racism. Well, because the gunman said that it didn't. Friends, this whole incident, the shooting, but also the news conferences, the headlines about massage parlors and sex workers, has everything to do with racism and misogyny. In the intersection of race and sexism toward Asian women in particular. It has everything to do with white supremacy, that a white suspect can say he's not racist and we believe him, even though he's just killed 6 Asian women. And we talk instead as if the women themselves in their 40s, in their 60s, working, bear at least a little bit of blame for doing those jobs. All of that, the headlines, the news conferences, our own assumptions and responses, have everything to do with the deadly sin that infects our country, our culture, our churches, our nice, white, middle-class society. Racism and xenophobia, misogyny and benevolent sexism, the kind of sexism that says, I'm complimenting them. I'm saying they're attractive. How can that be sexist or racist? Toxic masculinity that says the solution to lust or porn or sex addiction is to kill women. Toxic religion that's more concerned with the lust and porn and sex than with the violence and death that that religion itself has produced. These sins are closer to home than we would ever want to believe. They are sin that infects us, and it's deadly. And this story from John 12 is a repudiation of that sin, a promise of judgment upon it. And it is a promise of hope, of salvation for all. Welcome and salvation for sex workers and massage parlor employees and spa workers, who are not always or even often the same thing, by the way. For immigrants and their children and their great-grandchildren. For women and men who live in legitimate fear of violence because of their gender or sexuality, because of their skin color or last name or place of employment. It is welcome and salvation for white supremacists and good, polite white folk who don't like to call out our friends and family for their off-color jokes. Jesus says to them, to us, to the whole world, Jews and Greeks, whites, blacks and Asians, Americans and Chinese, the time has come. The time has come for me, the Holy One of God, the Son of humanity, to be lifted up, to be glorified. And that will happen in my death. Strangely, ironically, awfully, but also beautifully, the time has come for the salvation that will happen as I am lifted up in a humiliating death. And in that, God will be glorified. And the whole world will see salvation. Death will claim me for a moment, but then death will die. And my life will bear the fruit of life that is for all of humanity. I think there are a few appropriate responses to John 12 for us in America today, this week. First and foremost, always keep in the forefront of your mind, you are beloved. You are claimed by God, welcome to God's kingdom in Jesus. There is no sin, let alone any other part of your identity, race, gender, sexuality, occupation, that can prevent Jesus from calling you and embracing you. And the same goes for every person that you meet, every single human being. For God so loved the world. Second, because of that first and foremost truth, repentance is an appropriate response, I think especially for the white church. Remember, repentance is that big church word, but it simply means recognize your wrong thoughts and behaviors and invite God to change your heart and your life. And that means that repentance has to go beyond feeling sorry. Repentance means putting our time, our effort, our money behind those changes in our life. Find a charity or a not-for-profit this week that supports the AAPI, Asian American Pacific Islander community. Find one that's run by the AAPI community and donate your money. Where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Reach out to the AAPI folk that you know personally and say the hard, awkward thing. How are you doing this week? I'm so sorry. And then listen. Listen to their response. Just listen. And a third response, be like Philip. Grab a friend for courage, for companionship, for accountability, and spread the good news about Jesus. Make a way for others to come and see Jesus. And fellow white folk, let's start with our own family and friends. Tell them about the Jesus that was so radically welcoming that he made people mad because of who he hung out with, who he ate meals with. Tell them that Jesus doesn't like those off-color jokes about women or Mexicans or mail order brides, because Jesus knows their names and families and stories, and he calls them brothers and sisters. Tell them about the beautiful, diverse family that Jesus is pulling together and how it's way more fun than our divided society. Tell them about Jesus. Tell them about the Jesus of John 12. And invite them to come and see the one who said, "Now is the time for the judgment of this world. When I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to me." It's almost Holy Week, folks. The cross looms large. But on the other side of its death and violence, the death and violence that we keep choosing, we keep perpetrating, is an empty tomb. A life that only Jesus can offer us. And he offers it for all. Amen.
Savior. You are encouraged to share your prayer concerns by typing a name or a few words in the comment box on YouTube or Facebook, or by saying the names aloud. Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. You wash us through and through and remember our sin no more. Make your church a community of forgiveness throughout the world. Give all your people courage to forgive. Through your church, show the world new possibilities. Bless all ministries of repentance and reconciliation. God of all hope, hear our prayer. You fill the earth, from tiny grains of wheat to the mighty thunder, with your presence, and you call us to attend to your will for all creation. Grant weather that prepares the soil for seeds. Protect all from violent storms, flooding, and wildfires. God of all hope, hear our prayer. You sustain us with your bountiful spirit. Restore the joy of all who need to know your presence, those who are lonely or feel unforgivable, those who need healing of mind or body, those who are dying, and all who grieve. We pray especially for those on our hearts, whom we name now. God of all hope, hear our prayer. Jesus calls us to follow him in life and death. Empower this congregation in our ministries of discipleship. Equip children and teachers in Believers Club, Confirmation, Youth Group, Lenten Midweek Gatherings, Book Groups, Women's Circle, and all learning ministries. Especially as we look to the future and a new normal, give us your creative and wise spirit and teach us to follow Jesus. God of all hope, hear our prayer. In the cross of Christ, your name is glorified. We praise you for those who have given us words to worship you. With all those who have died in Christ, bring us into life everlasting. God of all hope, hear our prayer. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Gathered into one big family by the Holy Spirit, let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Take a moment, share a sign of peace with those around you, with those worshiping with you online, with those who are a text message away.
By your word and make my heart sing.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave with you, my own peace I give you." May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May God bless you that you might be a blessing. In the name of the Holy and life-giving Trinity, go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God. Have a great week and look out for our Holy Week schedule starting next Sunday with Palm Sunday and a palm parade in our parking lot. We hope you'll join us.
That's why I see all my hope. Been washed by